Creamy and smooth cheesecakes are a go-to dessert for pastry chefs. And now that we've got the basics covered with the New York-style cheesecake, it's time to move into something a little more advanced, individual chocolate swirl cheesecakes. Like the New York-style cheesecake, it all starts with the crust, except this time a chocolate variation. Graham crackers, as I had said, are made of whole wheat flour and honey. And now I'm playing on that idea and actually making a chocolate version, but starting with a cup and a quarter of whole wheat flour. And to this, I'll add 3 tablespoons of sifted cocoa powder, and I have a quarter cup of melted butter. And to add sweetness, just like a graham cracker has, I'm gonna add honey, 3 tablespoons. Just a little pinch of salt to this. Since the butter's still warm, the honey melts into it a little bit. And just stir it until blended. Now, because I'm making individual cheesecakes, I'm not using a springform pan this time. I'm using individual ring molds or tart rings. And I'll just put a couple of spoonfuls in the bottom. And then just using my fingers, press it in. There we go. Last one. These take 10 minutes to just bake and set in a 350 oven. So now I can start on the filling. And because it's a chocolate swirl cheesecake, I have to prepare the vanilla and the chocolate part separately. And I'm going to separate 2 eggs. A quarter cup of sugar. And to make this easier to whisk, 2 tablespoons of water. Doesn't matter what temperature, water. And vanilla bean paste, or you can use the scraped seeds of half a vanilla bean, so 1.5 teaspoons. So before I even add any cheese, I need to cook these ingredients together. And I'm going to do this in a water bath. The method's called sabayon, and I'm actually going to make this mixture more than double in volume. It's gonna be light and frothy, and the eggs will be fully cooked once I take it off the heat. This step replaces the need for baking the cheesecake. There we go. More than doubled in volume. You can see the vanilla bean seeds, but now for that essential component. Instead of using a traditional cream cheese, I'm using mascarpone cheese. I'm gonna use half the tub in the vanilla portion and use the other half in the chocolate portion. There we go. So it just melted right in. So vanilla's looked after. Now it's time for the chocolate. So again, 2 egg yolks. And a quarter cup of sugar. Instead of water, I'm going to whisk using coffee. I love how coffee enhances the chocolate flavor, so 3 tablespoons. So the same whisking until it's doubled in volume. There we go. Still pale and light, and you can smell the coffee in there. I have 2 ounces of bittersweet chocolate that I've just simply melted, and now's the time to add it while the mixture is still warm. That way, your chocolate swirl layer is smooth and creamy. Okay, to this, the remaining half of the tub of the mascarpone cheese. Whisking gently again. There we go. This version is done and nicely set now. But just like with the New York cheesecake, you have to cool your crust completely. And so these are cooled and ready to be filled. You can use 2 ladles, one for the vanilla, one for the chocolate if you wish, but I find pouring from a pitcher is far easier and a little tidier too. See, look how frothy and light that is. Chocolate. So the real trick here is to pour at the same time. Don't worry so much about the swirling now. I'll handle that with the skewer later. There's actually a seam right down the middle if you time it right. But don't worry if you get a few drips or drops. chocolate on vanilla or vanilla on chocolate, because the swirling fixes all that. And while still fluid, just simply take a bamboo skewer and give the cheesecakes a nice little swirl. That way, with every bite, you get a little vanilla and a little chocolate. There we go. Now I'll put these in the fridge so they can chill for a minimum of 6 hours. So after that mascarpone cheese has had a chance to set, it's time to serve the cheesecake. And using my offset spatula, just go down the side of the cheesecake to loosen it from the edges. Then pop it up onto your plate. You could garnish it with a few berries if you want, but I like to be able to show off that beautiful chocolate swirl. So sinfully rich and decadent.
Thanks for watching Oh Yum! Keep an eye on this channel for plenty of delicious recipes and more.